So if you walk on any job site in this entire country and you see anything up in the air, chances are it's slings that hold them there. But what is the working load limit? What does it take to break them? In this episode of The Rookie Professor, we find out. What's up guys, Devin here from MAZZELLA Companies, and today we're gonna break a synthetic round sling. We think it's important because you need to know exactly what the working load limit is of your synthetic round slings and what happens if you overload them. And to test this, I brought in some help. That is a buddy of mine here at the Cleveland office, and I set him on the floor here at Cleveland HQ to work with a guy named Jason. Now Jason is our proof tester. His job is to make sure that slings, chains, whatever, get tested so they can do exactly what they're ready to do, and then he maxes them out to see when they break and if they broke where they should have. So I'm gonna pass it to Thad, and he's gonna start by telling you the different tests a synthetic round sling goes through before you're ready to buy.
I found Jason inside, and he told me there were two tests to make sure my synthetic round sling was safe for the field.
Well, the process before it goes out on the field is called a proof test. What we do in the proof test is we take the vertical working load, which is, on this particular sling, it's 5:1, so the working load of this is 5,300. And we take that, we pull it up to 2 times the working load, which would be double that number, hold it for about 10 seconds, and then bring it back down.
The machine we'll use to test the sling has a carriage for pulling and a carriage for holding. A pin is dropped down to hold the sling in place on the pull side and on the hold side. Make sure the sling is entangled. Close the gate and we're ready to test. The pulling carriage slowly puts pressure on the sling. In our case, 10,600 pounds of it. And for the proof test, hold steady at that number till Jason ends the test. We inspect the sling for any damage, like tears or holes. And if it's clean, it passes.
We took it to the vertical load 2 times, which was it's 5,300 times two. And what that does is just make sure that that it's working properly and that it was made right.
Okay.
And the customer normally only goes by these numbers just to keep them safe.
So this is safe to use now in the field?
Yep, this is perfectly safe to go to the customer.
During the proof test, if something were to happen that it wasn't safe, what would happen?
All right, well, if it wasn't safe, then it would fail. And then after that, we would go to our inspector. Brian Guerra would look over it and find out why it failed.
So the next test we want to do is a break test. So how does that work?
Okay, well, a break test is when we take this all the way to maximum breaking strength, which is the 5:1 ratio. And for this particular sling, I believe it is 26,500 pounds.
Okay.
So 26,500 pounds, this should go boom.
The break test is set up the same way as the proof test, but instead of holding at a certain point, the pull carriage keeps on pulling until the sling fails. All right, so where did this thing break?
Okay, this thing broke at 33,100, so it broke at about 10,000 pounds over the manufacturer breaking strength, so that's excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. So what we do next is remove the pin, take it out, and look at the damage we got. This one pretty much broke underneath the sleeve. As you can see here, these are all the fibers that gives us all the strength. These fibers would normally be nice and smooth. They're all bunched up because they popped.
Right.
If it broke below the breaking point, we probably would pull out a few more
okay. And
break those to see where those break to get like an average breaking strength.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
That's it for today's episode. And I do hope that we were able to better help you understand the process a synthetic round sling goes through before it's able to be sold to you. If you like this video, consider checking out the rest of our Cranes 101 series or The Rigging Professor as well. There's a ton of content there. We're gonna make a whole bunch more. And if you subscribe to our channel, you won't miss out on any of it. If you have any questions or if you need help on your next lifting project, don't hesitate to reach out to one of our lifting specialists. They'd be happy to help you however they can. Thank you for watching.